Is This a Great State or What? Is sponsored by Weoki Federal Credit Union, celebrating 50 years of serving you and your family.
Welcome back. You know, if you have a typical job, you might think about retiring maybe in your 60s or 70s.
Yeah, but you know what? If you're an athlete, that retirement date could come a lot sooner. Tonight, Galen Culver has the story of a local fighter getting back into the game after a very long absence.
He's just another guy working out at the Quest Grappling Gym in Norman. Doors are open on a hot July night. No AC inside. Few distractions for the dedicated fighter. His fiercest opponent is himself.
I'll tell anybody, it doesn't matter what your art, your discipline, or what sport you think you're in, you don't know what fatigue is until you try boxing.
This fighter's name is Dave Harrod. He started boxing in his teens, had a long amateur tenure.
And I turned professional in 92, and my professional record at the time last was 7-1-1.
Until life took over. Time can pass as quickly as a rattling speed bag, moving so fast you can hardly keep up. Dave went to work, kids came along, but about 10 years ago he started to work out a little bit again. The kid they once called Pappy became a Pappy four times over, but he could still move. Harrod even thought he might be a better fighter than his younger self.
Instead of all that bouncing around, burning all that energy like you used to when you were in your 20s, you learned to slip and come inside and move with a guy not hitting you.
So a few months ago, he reapplied for his professional license with the Oklahoma Boxing Commission at the age of 51. And with permission from his wife and kids, he wants to fight for prize money against anybody who might dare to step in the ring.
So I said, hey, I can whoop that 51-year-old. I'd say, hey, let's find out. There's only one way to find out.
He is one of the oldest boxers in Oklahoma with a license to fight professionally. Dave had to submit himself to some extra medical tests, but he passed with flying fists. His kids come to some of his workouts now. They crowd around for a look through a different lens to see what Dad, the fighter, might look like, and, like us, to cheer him on for a little while longer.
The time is now. I'm not getting any younger. Someday there's not going to be another tomorrow.
In Norman, Galen Culver, News 4. Is this a great state or what?
And Dave is a longtime friend of KFOR. He was actually a live truck operator here for several years.
Yeah, he was also an engineer, and he's also really good at hacky sack. His plan is to fight as many as 5 more times professionally, and he's hoping for a shot at an Oklahoma championship in the welterweight division. We wish you the best, buddy.